Yo, what it do, family? It's your boy C's from thecslife.com. Thanks for checking in on me and continue to rock with me. It is Wednesday, and you know, pre-market right now. I'm actually in Scottsdale right now, waiting to train a couple of clients out here. But as I stated before, my prediction is that we are going to squeeze. Like, the squeeze is going to officially start on a Tuesday. I have no basis on this claim. It's just a gut feeling. As I mentioned before, this is not financial advice. That being said, since nothing happened yesterday, I feel that we're not going to be squeezing at all this week. I hope that I'm wrong, but I don't think that we're going to be squeezing this year, man. I just hope that I'm wrong. It's not fun. You know, we are going to squeeze, but we're playing with a different animal, you know, and they have resources beyond what we can comprehend. They have the ability to print money. You know, we're not just working with we're not just talking about the hedge funds, the market makers. We're talking about the government as well. You know, there's like so many people whose retirement and pensions are tied up into this mess, that they're not going to give in that easy, you know. And to give us, the majority of people, that much power over them, that's like, you know, it's foolish to think that it's going to come that easy, right? Yeah, it's easy to wait and be patient, but there's a lot of impatient apes that I've seen lurking in the forums and stuff. I get it. You know, like, some have been holding since January. I've personally been holding since June. So I get it. But I think that, you know, like, especially if you've done your research and you've seen the previous squeezes, some have taken as much as 2 years, right? So don't think that, you know, although this is probably going to be the biggest squeeze in history, that is just going to happen overnight. This might go on for a year, but just be prepared. You know, I've made it my point to continue living my life and continuing to hustle and continuing to create and generate more streams of income so that I can increase my position and also put my money in other places where it can work for me, right? So the next goal, of course, is going to be crypto, real estate, yada, yada, yada. But this squeeze might take a year, might take 2 years, who knows? These guys have so much power that they're able to control this situation. And this is supposed to be something that's like uncontrollable, right? But they still found a way to control it. So they're not going to give in. I don't think they're going to give it, like, because come on, man, like, the holiday season's coming upon us, and for them to go back to their clients and tell them, like, yo, we lost a gang of money, like, I'm thinking that they're going to find, they're colluding with the government to find a way to pay or fit the bill. Either the government is helping them pay these interest payments, you know, which would be freaking crazy, or they found some sort of loophole to kind of keep them in this game. So it's a waiting game. It's a patience game. They know a lot of people are going to be impatient. And I think that their goal is to make it so that the impatience have us sell at a lower price. Meaning, once this thing starts to squeeze, it's not going. They want apes to sell in the four digits or the five digits. They don't want to see the apes selling in the six digits. So they want us to wait as long as possible so that we're impatient, and as soon as the squeeze happens, we hit that sell button, you know? So that's just my thoughts, not financial advice. Just based on everything I've seen. I'm not a financial advisor. This is what I've seen doing my research and looking at Wall Street history and looking at, you know, the different messes that Wall Street has created for this country, and the way that they was able to escape it with just a slap on the wrist, right? So, yeah, just wait it out. be patient. Once the squeeze happens, know your exits. And yeah, man, don't let these guys win, because at the end of the day, we're in a power position. I don't think that this will ever happen again. So be on the right side of history. All right. Be on the right side of history. And yeah, of course, the moon. I can't wait to have a moon party, man, because speaking of impatience, I just can't wait to meet fellow apes and just share battle stories. Yeah, I am documenting this experience to, like, show, like, you know, my future self the heartache and headaches that we had to go through during these times. But at the end, I think it's all going to be worth it, man. Just hang strong. Ape strong. All right, so we're going to the gym. I'm using the GoPro and gonna be cruising to some poolside, man. Turn the AC down a little bit. Head out, man. Entrepreneurs in cars. Let's get it. Lower the volume so you guys can hear me a little bit. All right, y'all. So, in the previous video, I talked about how I think the hedge funds are colluding with the government, and the government are paying their interest payments. It really doesn't matter, because the shorts still have to cover. Only thing they're doing is delaying the inevitable. They're just trying to exhaust us apes into submission. And the submission meaning not us selling our shares and getting out of the position, but us giving them a discount, you know what I mean? Giving them a discount, meaning like instead of the six figure per share, we're giving them it at four figures or even five figures. I think right now the real share price is at the high four figures, and when the squeeze happens, it's going to go into the fives and the sixes, right? But right now, it's just a fake share price, because there's a lot of synthetic shares out there that they're playing with, you know? And they sold this float multiple times over, and they'll have to cover each and every one of those shares. So just imagine when the squeeze does happen, that interest rate that they'll have to pay is going to be even higher. So it's going to be like that snowball effect that they cannot control. And that price is just going to be catastrophic, right? So they're just trying to get a discount. And I think the government is trying to get a discount too, right? And as stubborn as we are, you know, they're just as stubborn. You know, they're trying to protect their egos. But ain't nothing worth to protect at this point, man. You guys are done. Like, get out of the game. You know what I mean? But their tenacity, you know what I mean? Like, they got some major cojones, man. Especially since they're playing with other people's money. You know what I mean? I think their money is going to be the last to go. They're going to make sure that they bankrupt all the pension plans, all the retirement plans, 401ks, etc., before they reach into their pockets and cover it with their pockets. So America's going to have to pay for this first. But the apes, even though we might get blamed for it, at least we have something to show for it, right? Like back in 2008, no one saw this coming, and they blamed Americans, everyday Americans, and they blamed even teachers, right? I really don't know why they blame teachers, but they blamed your everyday Joes except for themselves, right? They got their bailouts, they paid themselves a premium. And I think this is just sort of a way that the market is going to have to cleanse itself, right? This was an inevitable action. It was supposed to occur. This is a way that you drain the swamp, quote unquote, right? This is a way that the market self-cleanse and redistribute the wealth. Because for how long we've been saying that hedge funds, Wall Street have a way of, and corporations, they have a way of keeping all the wealth for themselves, right? They would have people sell really low, get out of their positions, the market would crash, have people get out of their positions really low, and use their bailout money to buy back stocks in their company, and then mark it up, right? So that their net worth are just ballooned to like these hundreds of billions of dollars. And you're like, how is this possible? Well, it's possible because they bankrupt America multiple times over. Then they'll buy their stocks back at a low discounted price and then just say, this is the price of my stock now. So they'll buy at $2 and they'll say, hey, this is the price of my stock now. It's at $300, $500, $600, whatever the case is. So they'll do this over and over. And you would say, like, man, the wealth gap is just extraordinary at this point. Like, this is the biggest wealth gap in history. But now the market is just self-regulating itself. Apes were able to come out of this haze, this coma, and they was like, yo, man, this ain't right. They found a way, man. I salute the original apes that found a way for us to fight back and reclaim what is ours. So once this whole saga is over, there's still going to be some fuckery. It's just going to be a different cycle, a different storyline, but same players at the end of the day. But again, it's just positioning, right? We'll be in a different position once this next thing happens. We'll probably be more awake to see them from a mile away and be able to capitalize from there. Anyway, here at the gym, I want to give me a quick little walking in and listen to some audiobooks, and I'll holler back.